Hey, welcome back to my plan channel. This is Max Waters Too Much, and today we're gonna go over some of my favorite, well, most of them are my favorite, so we're gonna be going over goth plants. Anyways, I got this idea from Pam's Pretty Plants. I love goth plants as well, so I'm just gonna be going over everything that's like red, purple, black, dark green, or gray even. I have a Alcacia over here, that's one of my favorites. Anyways, yeah, so let's get into it. Hey, but first, I'm gonna talk about the tea I'm drinking. This is Smashing Pumpkin Pie by Brutality. Like, most of their teas are based around like rock movies, whatnot. Yeah, this is a red rooibos, cardamom, cloves, cinnamon, ginger, natural pumpkin spice, orange, and vanilla flavors. It's really good. It's amazing, actually. But another one that I really like is a Krampus pistachio. It's like, it's all Krampus, you know? That one, I love anything marzipan, so that one's really good. And then there's Sweet Dreams Are Made of Teas. More like a sleepy time tea, a lot of herbal, chamomile, spearmint. I've seen some cornflower in that, yeah. But yeah, it's really good. Yeah. But yeah, you should check them out. Not sponsored, so if you want to like get on it, they're like a smaller business as well. So they have lots of flavors. There's all sorts. There's one that's like It's called Ruby Coco, and it's a lot of like raspberry and chocolate, like black tea. That one's really good. I like adding just a little bit of sugar and then like topping it off with some like chocolate milk, and it's like a hot chocolate with like raspberry. But yeah, I'll usually put milk in these, like coconut, almond, just normal milk as well. But yeah, they're really good. It's like lattes, so. So anyways, I might as well start it off with one of my saddest plants. It was doing well for a bit. It put out like a bunch of leaves, but now it's kind of slowed down a bit. You can see it. It's Calathea ornata. I love these like black leaves and the striping. It's like a pink, salmon-y pastel, I don't know. But of course, the undersides are like purple. There's like sugars from another plant on this. I think it's my hibiscus. I think it's like been blooming a lot, so I don't know if there's like any leakage on the flowers getting on this, cause yeah. I'll wipe this off. I gotta clean it anyways. And here, it's another Calathea. This one's a good one. Of course, it's Calathea lancifolia. It's like my first Calathea. I mean, it's not all that goth, but it's a favorite. Its undersides are like this bright red, of course. Okay. But yeah, love that dark green, the pattern. It's also called the rattlesnake. Anyways, plants that move on their own, kinda goth anyways, I don't know. They're kinda spooky and mysterious. Yeah, that's just gorgeous, stunning. Yeah, there's that one. Okay. And here's, this is one of my favorites, honestly. This one is, it's Pelionia ultra. It's been moved to it's been moved to Procris, like all Pelionias have. You can see that dark glitch of gorgeous foliage, and then you can see like that. I just love how it grows, and it's sparkly as well. Get this in the light. Anyways, okay, here's another one of my favorites. It's stunning. It is Cissus. It's Cissus discolor. It's Yeah, this is definitely one of my favorite plants. It's also called the Begonia Rex vine. Even though it's like in the grape family. Like you can see, let me find it, yeah. You can see like little tendrils that they use to grab onto stuff. And the leaves come out like super dark green and shiny. And on the back, there's just like this super deep dark purple that's also shiny. And they kinda mellow out, not get so shiny. Those leaves are stunning. But yeah, don't worry if like you see orange, like these orange bumps on the leaves. It just means that there's solids in your water that the plant just can't like respirate, you know? So they're just kind of stuck in there in the leaf. But yeah, it won't go completely away if you do switch to like filtered water or whatever. But anyway, it's in like a Frankenstein monster's pot as well, so that one's fun. And don't be fooled by the pot that I have this in. It is very much deep, dark, and mysterious. This is what the pot looks like, and I have some episcias in there. I love anything like fuzzy. I love gesneriads. I do love flowers as well, but you can see like these are deep, dark, chocolatey. But yeah, adorable pot. Its eyes don't follow you as you move throughout the room, so don't worry. Here's a favorite. Everybody talks about it. It is Simulacolcus Raven. It's the black ZZ. Mysterious. Anyways, yeah, I just love those dark leaves are to die for. And I have a little new guy popping up out of there. Yeah, this one's a cute little favorite. I love how small it is, honestly. But yeah, you know, it turns green, comes out green, then it kind of deepens and darkens. So, yeah. Here is a really cool Syngonium. This one is Syngonium erythrophytum. I think it's Liano Cardi Road. Yeah, I think it's like Iano, because I think it's a double L, I'm pretty sure. But it's gorgeous, and its stems are bright green. Just the deepest, darkest burgundy. It's stunning. Anyways, yeah, that one's a cool one. Over here, we have an orchid. We have a jewel orchid. It's like, they call them jewel, like a jewel orchid. And it is Oesiocleides spathulifera. It's really cool. It has like a bulb as well. And the foliage is amazing. It's sparkly as well. When I get like a light on it. But yeah, this one's really cool. I'm always in like orchids, especially terrestrial stuff as well. They're just the coolest. Like the habitat for this one, it lives in like Madagascar. Like, kind of around the edges of like the rainforest, like going towards the sand dunes, which is really cool. But yeah, it's like, I'm sure this one, you could probably but I'm sure it could handle like more salt as well, since it's like getting a lot of that on the sand dunes. Anyways, yeah, it's kind of more. Yeah, it's really cool. Anyways. Yeah, for another orchid. This one's dormant at the moment. But yeah, this is Monterera Millennium Witchcraft. Yeah, it's really cool. Yeah. Monterera Millennium Magic Witchcraft. But yeah, this one. It has gorgeous, like, black flowers when it does bloom. But yeah, it's a Catasium type, and a lot of them are deciduous, so they do drop their leaves when it does get, like, darker and cooler sometimes. But anyways, yeah, this guy, whenever spring comes up, he'll start putting out new growth. Very exciting. But yeah, it's also fragrant. I've heard it, people say it smells like medicine, like mint, like almost like chest rub. And then some that's more like licorice and like kind of a little bit like root beer. But I don't know if that's kind of like flowers are black and people just make the like connection to like black licorice anyways. Yeah, here is the great one I was talking about. This is Alocasia Maharani. This one's really cool. This one's been like so easygoing. It's all loose in its pot. I think I kept it at 10, but to it, and it didn't like that the most. See, the undersides are red when it starts to mature more. It just gets like super deep and dark. See, this leaf's like hardened off. And the texture, it's insane. It feels like a bouncy ball. Like those really rough ones that you get as a kid. Yeah, that one's a really cool one. Yeah. Here is my little black goldfish plant. This guy's really cool. He's got the reddish undersides as well. They get like, they're more red on the tips of the leaves than they are like the centers or whatever. Anyways, this one's cute. Like I said, I love anything that's like a Cnereids. So like the Episcia and this one as well are really cool. I have too many plants in this video, but there's one that I like. It's called Mania. It's like Purpura Vita Vitata. That's what it is. It's like Purpurescens Vitata. Yeah. And that one's really cool. I mean, it's just a little guy at the moment. Nothing to write home about, but like as it starts maturing and whatnot, it does get these like gorgeous tubular flowers that are like purple and yellow striped. I don't know, the color's like Mardi Gras. It's like wild, but yeah. Anyways, this is my Hoya. This leaf's probably gonna die off anyways, but yeah, this is Hoya. Haudata Sumatra, yeah. You can see it's like spooky, and I mostly put this in here because this leaf is dying off, and it's just like the most gorgeous like autumn, like Halloween, fall colors. Anyways, it's like I might as well put this in here because it's really cool as well. And the flowers, when it does flower, they're like fuzzy, which are really cool. And okay, the last plant I have in this video is in a terrarium. You saw me unbox this one, I think. I got it from Brooke's Tiny Journey. It's this gorgeous one. I know my terrarium is dirty. Anyways, I'll put in some video, like close up the flash on to show you like how cool it is. I think it's Autumn Ember, but like on the edges, they're like black, and when a light hits them, they're like blue, which is really cool. Yeah, anyways, thank you again for joining me on this video. This is probably gonna be one of my longest videos. I'm not the greatest at like long form content, I think. I don't know. But anyways, thank you for joining me on my plant journey. Anyways, thank you very much. If you wanna like do the whole goth plant thing, do it. Just make a video on it. Gorgeous plants that are black and dark and beautiful. But yeah, this is gonna be the end of the video. Thank you for watching. I haven't said this before, but like and subscribe if you want to. I don't wanna like pressure you into doing anything, but you should do it. But yeah. Bye.